Let's take a look at Fairlight in DaVinci Resolve and ask who should actually learn Fairlight and how much. What are the advantages of going to Fairlight, or is it maybe enough to do audio from the edit page? How is it if I just need to get stuff done quickly, or if I'm on a short film, for example, and I really want to tweak things? I cannot answer all these questions. That's why I have a professional with me. Gavin Lucas is here. He has been teaching audio for over 20 years, and he has just completed a very comprehensive Fairlight course for VFX study. Gavin, welcome to the channel.
Hi, Bernd. Thanks for the invitation.
I'm a VFX guy who is publishing YouTube tutorials from time to time. One microphone, one music track, that's pretty much it. Do I need Fairlight?
To be honest, no. But it can have many advantages using it.
And I am using some, but maybe I change some things after this tutorial. We'll see. Thanks to Audiio for supporting this video, and let's dive in. Okay, let's start directly from my scenario. I'm one person talking with a microphone. I put maybe a little bit of music under the track. From every tutorial is pretty much the same process, and it needs to be fast. So I can do all of this from the edit page, right? So what advantage can I find in Fairlight?
Of course, as you said, you can do all that in the edit page. Most people will probably start with that, which is absolutely okay, I think. But you will see that there are a lot of things that you have to do every time. If we look at the edit page, even though I have access to most of the important settings like voice isolation on track basis or equalizer, but on clip level only, there are other important things that are missing, such as track-based effects, a decent preset management, compressor settings, and many other things that can help me to get a good sound. So if I go to the Fairlight page, there we have a preset management. I can open the preset library, and there you not only have presets for several of your effects like equalizer presets or dynamic presets, you even can use global track presets. And in my case, of course, I have prepared several presets for me and some of my other colleagues here. For example, if I want my YouTube preset for channel 1, I can just select the channel and apply the preset, and it will not only apply all the settings and effects, but also adjust the timeline according to my preset. And there you can see here right away, I'm using voice isolation. I have a plugin already set up with the correct settings. I'm using the dynamic section, the compressor, equalizer, and everything is right away set up for my project. So I'm saving a lot of time by preparing those presets and applying them just with one click here.
So project level presets and track level presets, I have both for myself, and including one for when the AC is on and one when it's off. So that's very useful. Let's talk about one more thing, putting in music. So for me, that's pretty simple, just putting in a track in the beginning, bit of fade in, fade out. But let's say I want to do a tiny bit more. Gavin, can you show us something here which is generally useful for pretty much everyone who is doing YouTube videos?
Yes, for example, if you're using music, sometimes it can be very helpful to have orientation for the beat of the music, and Fairlight offers some very interesting things here. Let's zoom a little bit in here. I have a music track and I want to do some syncing for my editing and things like that. And here I have a guide, grid view options, where I can switch my time-based to tempo-based. So if I know the tempo of my track, for example, I have just downloaded one music track from our partner Audiio, and they give the information about the tempo. So I know that's 125 BPM, so I can enter that here and display that tempo grid here, which I can use for orientation. And set the case here in my example, the beat of the music doesn't start directly at the beginning of the clip, but a little bit later. So here's some kind of fade in, some kind of intro, and the beat starts here. And of course, I can measure where the beat starts. I have done that before. And then I can enter the correct start, for example, here. I think that should fit if I remember it correctly. And now I have a guideline for every beat here for my music track, and I can use that for editing and syncing things to the beat. And even if it comes to editing, there are many advantages if you're working in the Fairlight page. It would be too much to mention, but just for example, if it comes to syncing video with audio, which can be important for YouTube videos too, for example, with audio stingers and things like that, you have advanced possibilities here in the Fairlight page for syncing, and you can work on frame or even subframe precision for moving and syncing your audio materials here.
Thanks, Gavin, for sharing these simple tricks that can be beneficial for every YouTube production. Some people, of course, have more complex audio demands. We will have a look what we can do there. But before, you can only produce great sounding videos if you have great source material available. And as a first step, having access to a high quality music and sound FX library is essential. Gavin used just now a music clip from Audiio, and that's where they excel. Audiio offers an excellent and growing library of high quality music from real musicians and real composers. All material is very well curated and organized and searchable. And one interesting feature for music is their Link Match AI feature. Perhaps you have used some temporary music in your project and you want to find something similar that you can license to. As long as you can find the song somewhere like on YouTube or on Spotify, you can just put a link and LinkMatch AI will give you matching alternatives that you can license, and perhaps you find something that matches your video even better. Check out Audiio via the referral link below this video to get 70% off for your first year subscription. And with that, let's go back to the tutorial. Let's look at a slightly more advanced scenario where we have any form of dialogue recording. Whenever you have something that's not 100% perfectly controlled, like one person speaking, you immediately have some problems usually. In the edit page, if I have the studio version, I can directly turn on voice isolation and let the AI take over. Other than not having the studio version, I assume there's still some cases where I need to do something manually, right? And that's probably where Fairlight comes in.
Yes, exactly. You can do many more things in Fairlight that can be helpful here other than using the AI tools. Fairlight offers a lot of more options for optimizing and cleaning up your sound. Of course, also in this scenario, you could do some of the things in the edit page, but in the Fairlight page, I think it's much more convenient and faster, and you have more tools at your hand, and you even can go up to sample basis level and fix glitches, for example. Regarding effects, you have more tools for fixing all kind of issues, and on top of that, you get a much more better overview and control of what you are doing in regards of adjustments and effects placed in your mix, whether on clip or track basis. Furthermore, I think one important thing is, if you're working with dialogue, you want your dialogue to sound good, of course. And here in Fairlight, there are some more audio options offered only in the Fairlight page, like equalizers and compressors or things like that on track basis, or ducking, where you can lower some music track every time someone speaks. All that can be done very well directly from the Fairlight page.
So when it comes to audio effects, cleanup effects, etc., I can put them in on the edit page, but in Fairlight, I have first of all the bigger mixer panel, and the layout just gives me some advantages, and I can see the effects side by side and arrange things a bit better for my purpose.
Yes, sometimes when doing trainings or working with clients, I can see that it can be problematic if you're trying to do everything in the edit page, because it can get a little bit messy if you're using a lot of effects on channel or clip basis. But when working in the Fairlight page with its big mixer and its overview, you are able to see everything at one glance. And that's one thing. The other thing is that certain options are only available in the Fairlight page. So really a lot of things, little small things that can speed up your work. And one thing to mention maybe is you can even integrate a third-party software and access it from the Fairlight page, for example, for doing things like spectral cleaning, which can be useful in some cases. And those programs can be integrated and used directly from the Fairlight page.
Now let's look at a more advanced scenario. Let's say you want to really push your film to the best possible outcome. You really want to succeed in the film festival or wherever with your movie and get the best possible sound. So typically that involves putting in a lot of stuff, right? So really building rich soundscapes, rich environments through sound. In this case, you no longer have two, three tracks that you find like at the bottom of the edit page, but you can probably easily fill the screen in Fairlight. So what advantages do you have there now when it comes to mixing that film?
Yes, good question. Naming all the tools, I think, would go beyond the scope of this video. But for example, you can easily handle a lot of tracks. There's nearly no limitation. And when it comes to mixing, beside the fact that you have all the professional tools, you even can use a technique that's called automation, where you can record your mixer movements while playing back. With that concept, you can not only control the volume of your channels, but also every other important parameter of your mix. And you can do this with your mouse, or you can use external hardware for that. There's even special hardware from Blackmagic Design, but you can also use other hardware or even applications for tablets, things like that, for doing mixing and mixing automation. And Fairlight gives you all the tools for doing a professional mix, including making presets for your mixing. So if you want to compare certain mixes, you can store them as a preset in Fairlight and compare them for your client or the director. So you can just compare it, and that's very beneficial in some cases. Another important thing is that you can use special tracks for maybe effects or dialogue or ambience, and you can prepare that in Fairlight, and you can route everything, every signal to every track. And a real case scenario maybe could be you have a scene, a garage, for example, and there's reverb and delay. So you can set up one track with the correct reverb and delay, and every other track or dialogue and sound effects where you want to use this reverb and delay, you can just route certain amounts of your signal to the effect track. So that's the professional way of doing that. And if the director or you at a certain point thinks I want it to sound different, then you can quickly change that at one point, and all the reverb effects in your mix will be changed immediately. So that's the professional way of doing that, and you can do that in Fairlight.
Okay, so you really get a lot of flexibility and more advanced tools to organize big mixes. Another thing, let's go one more time back to dialogue. We already spoke about fixing dialogue, but sometimes it just cannot be fixed or not to the best possible quality, but you need to re-record this. We speak about automatic dialogue replacement, ADR, or simply any form of dialogue recording or voiceover recording. Here I can again go to Fairlight. Do you want to show that to us?
Yes, I even can show you a little example here from my Fairlight tutorial where I explain how to use the recording in general. So how to set up Fairlight for doing audio recordings with your audio hardware. And that's just a simple way of doing that. If you're working on bigger projects, bigger productions, then maybe you want to do a thing called ADR, so dialogue replacement, where you have voiceover actors or the actors of your movie doing the voiceover recordings afterwards. And Fairlight offers all the tools and possibilities for ADR recordings. So even if you're a small production company, or maybe you're just one person, you can do that in your studio, or even for big productions or big studios, you can set up an external room or a cabin for your voiceover recordings and remotely record your speakers from there. So Fairlight really offers all the tools you would need for that.
All right, so now I have the best possible mix and clean dialogue and everything. Now I need to get it out to my film festival. So can I just go to the delivery page and choose a format and that's it? Or is there more to distribution where Fairlight can help me?
Of course, you could do that. But of course, I think there are some more things before doing that. For example, certain delivery platforms require certain delivery standards. For example, if you're producing for Netflix or Disney or any other standard for worldwide distribution, there are presets in Fairlight which will help you to analyze your audio if everything's okay for that certain delivery standard, and you can find problems and fix them. This way you can ensure that the customer accepts your recording, your production. And on top of that, you can of course do multi-channel productions or international versions with different languages, and you can all do that in one mix, in one project here in Fairlight. For example, you can already prepare your stereo mix, you can prepare 5.1 or even Dolby Atmos, other things like that. You can do that directly in DaVinci Resolve Studio and deliver several formats at once for your clients, for example.
So we see we can go into pretty advanced territory here, speaking about Dolby Atmos mixes and international distribution, etc., etc. Can I really do everything to the very end in Fairlight, or are there cases where I might have to leave Fairlight, get additional software, or say, okay, this project is too big, Fairlight can't do it?
Yes, good question. Too big, I think it's not a problem. Fairlight can handle very big projects. But of course, there might be other certain things you normally wouldn't do in Fairlight. So if it comes to mixing and editing for film, I would say you can do everything right away in Fairlight. Sometimes you even might want to use external tools for maybe spectral editing or things like that, but you can integrate them directly, so you would not need to leave Fairlight for that. So that's not a problem. But for example, if you really want to compose music for film or whatever, Fairlight isn't the right tool for composing music. But it's the right tool if you want to bring that music into your film and integrate that in your mix. So yes, I would say there are some scenarios if you want to compose music, but for all other things, in most cases, I think you can find everything you need directly in Fairlight.
Okay, so we have covered a lot here. Gavin, anything else we should mention for this tutorial?
Yeah, one thing I would like to mention, of course, in scope of this video, we really can speak about everything what's inside Fairlight. And maybe you still think Fairlight is just the right thing for you if you're doing big productions, but I really think that's not the case. Even if you are working just on your private projects or YouTube videos for your private purposes, you can really benefit a lot from using the tools and possibilities given in Fairlight. So there are a lot of tools, and if you know how to use the tools, they can really, really speed up your work and improve your audio a lot. So some of them are little things, some of them are big things or tools, and if you know how to use them, you can benefit a lot from that. And of course, in our tutorial, the Fairlight tutorial I did together with Bernd, you will learn everything that's inside Fairlight. And I think regardless of the projects you're doing, you can benefit from using the Fairlight page because audio is a very important and sometimes maybe underestimated part of a film.
All right, so there's definitely a lot to learn and a lot of small and big tricks in Fairlight that can help us. That's why, first of all, we have four more tutorials coming up here on VFX Study. And then Gavin has recorded a very, very comprehensive course where he looks into all those small little details, everything from dialogue processing all the way to working with the biggest mixes and dealing with those. The course is extremely systematic, very comprehensive. So if you need to learn Fairlight end to end, check it out on vfxstudy.com. Thanks Gavin for taking part in this tutorial, and stay tuned for the upcoming ones with Gavin here on VFX Study. Thanks to Audiio for supporting this entire series of tutorials, and thanks to you for watching. See you next time. Cheers.